Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Dr. Arora on stage.
I think we're all really excited and motivated after Mickey's talk, and I listen to him on radio practically every day where he comes on the morning show with Rishikesh Kannan and Mickey mizes our day every day. So thank you, Mickey, for that. And of course, Mr. Puri's start was extremely interesting as well. I've been in the healthcare industry for all my life. I've been running a chain of diagnostic centers for over 25 years now. And over these years, I have come across some very interesting patient journeys and patient stories. Many of them have impacted me, and I will share two of those stories with you today. This lady, Gayatri, came to me about 20 years ago with her sister for a regular health checkup. And during the health checkup, I found out that, she looked like there was a early incidence of blood cancer. So I called her up and I asked her, what symptoms does she have? And she said she's just feeling generally weak, but no other symptoms. So I called her back to repeat the test, and on repeating the test, I confirmed that she did have blood cancer. I called her in the evening with her husband, and I told them that, you have acute myeloid leukemia or blood cancer, and I'm recommending that you go and see a hematologist in a particular hospital that I knew. Fortunately, they took my advice. They went to see the hematologist, who advised a bone marrow transplant for her. Since they could afford, they went and got ahead a bone marrow transplant. And today, after 20 years, she's cured of a condition which otherwise had a life expectancy of just a few weeks. The best treatment for cancer is prevention. The next is early detection. This is a story of this boy who I met 25 years ago. He was one of my first patients at the age of 8. And Abhay would come for a blood test all by himself. Can you imagine an 8-year-old boy coming for a blood test just by himself? I was really intrigued that how can a boy come, unaccompanied and be so bold and say, "Doctor, check my hemoglobin." I didn't know that he's been used to needles all his life. He has a condition called thalassemia major, where he needs a blood transfusion every 21 days because of his genetic condition. The body is not able to make adequate amount of red blood cells. He takes blood transfusions. Because he takes blood transfusions, he has to take medicines to remove excessive iron. He has to put a pump overnight to remove the excessive iron. Till date, he has taken over 500 blood transfusions and counting. He's had every complication that I can think of, but he's still fighting. Genetic conditions in our country are very slow on the understanding. I think we're still grappling with many more, so genetic conditions don't get that kind of attention. Only if his parents knew that instead of matching their horoscope, all they had to do was match their thalassemia profile, such conditions can actually be avoided. These two stories talk about the importance of early detection, picking up diseases at a stage where you can actually reverse them or you can treat them. Just imagine the impact of these diseases on the individual, on the family, and on society. And it is our endeavor to actually bring down this impact, this burden, something that I call unburden your health. I'd just like to show a small video on that. Just imagine if, these trends of being proactive, early and correct diagnosis was applied not just to society, but to the country at large. Just imagine the extent of which diseases could be picked up at a stage where we could actually either prevent them or treat them or reverse them. This is what we want to do, is to bring down this burden of diseases in our country. Health in our country is, reactive because of out-of-pocket expenses. We only go to the doctor when we fall ill. It is our endeavor to change the life cycle of a patient. You must go to a doctor not when you fall ill, go to a doctor to actually remain healthy. Can I have a quick show of hands as to how many of you have sought an appointment with a specialist, for a back pain or some, niggling condition, and were told that you have to wait for a week or 15 days or a month to get that appointment? I see a few hands coming up. So there is a big gap between demand and supply in our country with healthcare. We have, like in the West, the disease trend is moving from infectious to non-communicable diseases, yet we have less than one doctor per 1,000 population. We have increased demand, we have life expectancy that is going up, but we have less than one bed, and we have limited public funding for it. Our middle class is increasing, the affordability is increasing, but do we have enough skills in the healthcare industry to be able to match that gap? And that is why there is a need to bring down this burden of health in our country. So how can we do more with less in healthcare? Healthcare in India, I believe, is becoming increasingly transactional. And it is our endeavor to change that. We want to remain relevant. We want to make sure that we do the right things for the patients and the doctors at the right time, using technologies which are current, like molecular technologies or genetic technologies. We want to make sure that we treat most of the conditions in the OPD so that only what needs to go into the IPD goes into the hospitals. So keep people out of the hospital as far as possible. Diagnostics, if you see on this image, scans the entire continuum. There is one part which is treatment, which is a focus of attention, but diagnostics goes right from prevention right up to monitoring. So diagnostics, I believe, has the potential to be a paradigm shift in the way in which healthcare is approached. Diagnostics plays an important role. Almost 70% of decision making happens because of diagnostics at less than 10% of the cost. It is also very important. I have a very, common saying that a good surgeon is one who knows when not to operate. Similarly, a good lab should be able to tell you when to do a test and when not to do a test. Wasteful expenditure, bringing that down, is also trying to unburden healthcare. And we all are talking about increasing lifespan, but it is our endeavor that don't look at lifespan, look at health span. So the focus should be on moving away from the lifespan and trying to focus on the health span. And we looked at few conditions which we as a diagnostic lab can support in. So on one side, we have malnutrition, which is prevalent in our country, but at the same time, we have obesity also as a challenge. We have India is probably the pregnancy capital of the world, yet we have 20% of pregnant women who are dying of a simple condition called anemia. We have infectious diseases that are continuing to rise, yet we have drug resistance. That's a big problem in our country. So how do we tackle this? We, all of us, have an elderly in our family, and we are afraid that somebody will fall and have a fracture. All that needs to be done is to do a BMD or a bone scan once a year. This is the data that we did, that less than one in 500 women who came to our centers voluntarily did a bone scan. But of the women who did, the majority were osteoporotic. Now, only if all women started doing that. So we started to incentivize this habit by saying age equals to discount. So the older you are, if you're 75 years old, you get 75% discount. So we want to incentivize positive lifestyle choices. Similarly, for a health checkup, we said if your BMI is 25, you get 25% discount. If your BMI is 30, you get 30% discount, because higher the BMI, more the need to go in for a health checkup. So how can we work together to incentivize positive lifestyle choices? We've also used our data to showcase what is the drug sensitivity pattern prevalent in the local community, sharing this data with the doctors to make sure that they practice better, they prescribe the right antibiotics. If not needed, downgrade the antibiotic to bring down the incidence of drug resistance. Just imagine what we can do if we all started incentivizing positive lifestyle choices. So like I said, the BMI and the BMD, how do we encourage people to come for a health checkup? We have something called as a Connect Four program. Four friends, four ladies of a kitty party, two couples in a building come together. We give you a game called Connect Four. You enjoy playing that game. You get your health assessed. You enjoy a healthy breakfast. All this to make preventive health more fun and more enjoyable. We started incentivizing people by sending out a birthday wish one day before their birthday. Now, I do this on my birthday every year. I do a health checkup on my birthday because I believe the best gift that I can give myself is good health. We all take insurance for our families, but the true insurance that we can actually give our family is our good health, being there for them when we actually need. So when we saw this trend, we started going out and we saw that almost 500 people now use that incentive and come back and do a health checkup on their birthday. So I want to leave you with asking you this question. How will you celebrate your next birthday? How will you celebrate your next anniversary? Thank you.